Hey, welcome back everyone, Jay Barino here, continuing Celestial Irruption. This is part two of the first mission. We're on Nilokor, and we're defending against a coup of some sort by the Resistance. They're trying to depose the Emperor Cowlin, so we are now have a timer because somebody thought it was a good idea. Somebody, Desler, thought it was a good idea to have an hour and a half long holdout segment, which is just crazy to me. Anyway, we're still here, and my goal right now is to make a lot of tanks and to help support my ally while we get set up here. So let's do that. I'm just gonna get some factories down in their base. And we've got some extra tanks. We're gonna set these up over here because we do have two entrances and we have to defend them both. We have this entrance and then another entrance elsewhere. So let's set these tanks up right here. And I have a large air force that's being set up, so I'm pretty happy with that. But I think I wanna focus on Goliaths now as well. So let's do that. We've got our hip music starting. So where do I want to set up my supply depots? It looks like I have a bunch set up over here. I haven't played this for about a week, so I'm trying to remember where everything was. How are my upgrades going? They're all going. Let's go ahead and just keep setting up missile turrets. And it really just depends on where they come from, because it looks like we've got enemies coming from down here into my friendly base. And what I might do is grab some of my air forces and go down and try to rescue them. Not really rescue them, but try to keep them above water for now. So let's do that. I mean, we're looking good. We're gonna have good upgrades, things like that. So let's just make sure we come on over and keep trying to help them. And then once these factories are done, which they are now, I'm gonna start pumping out Goliaths and siege tanks from them and then take these SCVs and just start setting up tons and tons of turrets all around here. All right, so here comes the enemy. And I guess I should have expected them to come from this direction. So I'm gonna wanna get more tanks and Goliaths and move out and probably set out some defense outside of my base. That might be a mistake, but I think this is how I want to do it. All right, this SCV is bothering me, so let's get rid of it. All right, it's gone. And then we want to start getting as many Goliaths out here as possible. I know I just queued up a crap ton, and that's how it is. Did I lose? I must have lost a bunch of raids that I sent down here. That's too bad. Okay, so we've got some Goliaths coming out. Let's go ahead and move all of these units down here. And yeah, it appears as if they are attacking me from over in this direction. I did get Charon boosters, that's good. Let's go ahead and take Emperor Cowlin and move out over here. Pretty large groups of units over in this direction. Let's go ahead and bring my SCV up here and just start setting up turrets on the outside. All this research is complete. I don't know what the hotkeys are for armor and such, so let's go ahead and set these up. And cancel these Goliaths and make some siege tanks instead. And like I said, I'm just gonna surround this area with turrets. This is going to be my little holdout here as this group tries to defend themselves. Let's go ahead and send my dropship back home, and we'll bring some more SCVs down. And we're looking good on income, I think. Mining from there. Okay, Emperor Cowlin, we can't really risk this. Let's get you back home, and we're going to make some extra SCVs. Okay, and my Valkyries are doing their job. Wonderful. That is a lot of tanks. Let's get inside of our base here and cancel this. And we need to set up... Wow, that is a lot of tanks. We need to set up more stuff here. So let's unseize these. And then move these out of the base and try to get them over here if possible. Now, they're not sieging up, so we should be in really good shape. Let's just attack down in this direction and see if my tanks can even fit through here. They are barely able to. And we need more Goliaths as well. So we're going to rally outside of our base. And they're taking out some of my depots. That's okay. Get in there, Valkyries. Okay, so let's take my siege tanks and set them up a little further up here. I think this will be good. And is this burning down? It is slightly. Where's the Emperor? We want to make sure that we repair him promptly. Lots and lots of Goliaths coming out. What I'm going to do is unseize these tanks and move them up towards the edge. And then we just need to set up a lot of missile turrets. And we're going to defend this area with Goliaths. As the pathing is the bane of my existence, as usual. Go ahead and siege up here. I think I canceled the music. Once I think the timing loops, it'll start again. I hope. Another thing I could always do is just go ahead and just reload my save. Like, I can save right now. And then load it up, and the music should be playing, so. Hitting escape too much does do that. Here's Graythan still. There's the music, and what's going on over here? Here's our Let's get our tank set up over here, and then SCV come on down here and repair this area. And then where else do we really need turrets? Just all probably up in this direction. This is where a lot of the enemy seems to be coming and attacking me. That's hopefully not going to be a big deal. We want to pull some of these SCVs down here to make turrets. And maybe even bunkers. It seems like this area didn't really need defending that much. I'm tentative to leave my base. I kind of want to, but I'm very tentative to. Let's get Caduceus Reactor, even though we don't really need it, but let's get it. And yeah, the game speed was not reset. Whoopsie daisies, that's okay. Okay, so let's start getting all this set up. Got a pretty large enemy attack coming into the entrance of this area. Let's go ahead and set up my own tanks here. We've got our Goliaths wherever we want to leave them. We have to decide where we want to leave these. Okay, so this is where all this kind of stuff is happening. So let's get up here and see if we can defend our turrets. This is why I wanted to set up turrets here. Over here as well seems like the area where we need to leave this stuff. All right, so let's go ahead and start trying this again and leave these folks here. Meanwhile, my Goliaths that I built down in this area, I'm going to move over here. And I just want to defend as much of this base as possible. I don't see a reason not to try. And we need more depots, so I'm going to just keep building them over in this direction. We're going to need a very large group of Goliaths for when that large group of battle cruisers gets to our base. And it is a large group. Okay, no problem. Let's move some of the Goliaths up here, because this seems like where they're primarily really coming from here. There's also, I could take this base over here. There's a lot of money over here. I do have all of these bases set up. I'm feeling comfortable with my income. Just making sure that we're okay. And then we do have all of our upgrades here. Here's what I'm going to do. You guys back up, is we're going to just destroy this armory here. We're going to destroy both armories here. We only need one at this point, so that's fine. Now we have a space to get through. We can leave some Goliaths back here, and then go ahead and just repair my missile turrets. And there's no auto-repair, unfortunately. Auto-repair is just wonderful when it comes to holdouts, but unfortunately, we don't have it. I might want to get some extra Wraiths or Valkyries. I think Valkyries are the right choice. Granted, my Wraiths can cloak. Okay, so now here we go. Did these just spawn here? What happened? They must have just spawned here. Yeah, they're spawning right on top of me. Okay, so where's my other... I had another SCV here. Maybe I lost it. Was it building something? Oh, I see. Okay, so I see how the attacks are coming in certain locations. There's a side disruptor here. That's interesting. Let's leave some of these Goliaths here and then move the rest down here. We have to defend against these battle cruisers. My missile turret does manage to survive. Let's get my SCV down here to repair this or just make more. Let's go ahead and do that. Wraiths coming in. We need more Goliaths and Goliaths. We have a large group of Wraiths down here. They might come and attack me elsewhere, so we need to be prepared to go and meet them. So we have a little air force right here. Let's go down and meet this group of Wraiths. That's a pretty large group. 57 minutes, that's a long time to go. So we just gotta keep building and building and building. And we gotta not stop with our depots so that we can make sure that we can keep building more when we really want to. Okay, so let's go ahead and hotkey this. I feel like I'm getting some weird frame rate issues. Very interesting. All right, let's come on down here. Your bunkers aren't even full up, are you crazy? These people are really killing me here. All right, let's get down here and make sure we defend it. Well, it's defended right now, but let's make sure we're well defended. Meanwhile, let's go ahead and keep making these. And where's my dropship? I want to make sure to grab some of these SCVs to bring them down into this base to keep making just a butt ton of tanks and turrets and all that to just keep this set up for as long as possible. We just need more tanks at the front there. We have these Goliaths who are going to do their best to hold on to this area. I'd like more missile turrets there if possible. Okay, keep it up. Turrets. And we've still got the Goliaths coming out. That's good. More depots, please. Okay, and then we have this small group, maybe more Valkyries, or did I make more Valkyries? There they are. So this is group one, my anti-air group. Okay, and then we want to send a few more Goliaths up into this direction. So let's send these up here. I'm not sure what this side disruptor is for, but it's here, so whatever. Let's go ahead and move up one SCV up here to start making turrets, and one SCV, I suppose, up here to make groups of turrets. It really just depends on how frequently they decide to attack us. Did I lose a tank? I must have accidentally run a tank off in a bad direction. Okay, so I feel very well defended at home. It's really just consolidating in Brown's base. Brown is kind of delaying for me, and the longer I can keep him alive, the better. Upgrade's going well. I'm going to go ahead and save because I'm feeling pretty comfortable. And we just got to get this base set up as quickly as possible. So let's grab this tank. Come on over here. We're going to set you up. More and more turrets, please. As many as possible. And let's grab a couple Goliaths and run them up here because we want to defend this area until we can get a bunch of turrets set up. I'm going to make another run for SCVs back at home. Almost mined out here. We'll get another depot. And more depots. That should do it. Okay, so we're still getting tanks here. I think this amount of tanks is good. Otherwise, we're gonna run out of space. Okay, so yeah, this is the area, and we're just gonna slowly try to creep closer and closer to where they're sending these units from. Okay, you guys back up. And yeah, we still have this area set up. Go ahead and repair this missile turret. We've got a lot of Goliaths here that are ready to defend this area. So now that I kind of have it locked down which direction they come from, I think we're in good shape. I can keep making turrets over here. Let's just finally repair this one. I am not afraid of these attacks. These wraiths are just pretty much suiciding into me. Unfortunately, I have no friendly wraiths, so that kind of hurts. Okay, and then you Goliaths move on up here. Hold position. Hold position, and the enemy is not using any sort of... The enemy doesn't seem to have any sort of siege mode, so we should be in really good shape. And I'm just gonna make as many turrets as necessary up in these directions. And we might want to set up some, like, up here as well, just in case. Just everywhere. How are we looking on minerals up here? This is mined out, so I did send my dropship back up, didn't I? Where did it go? I thought I sent my dropship back up to make a run for SCVs. Well, it's missing. So at this point, I'm just going to keep making turrets. I think that's really all I need to do, is just non-stop turret production. Here, and then also here. I'm going to grab a few of these Goliaths. This is a few too many, and we're going to move them up in this direction as well. Okay, and I'd really like to go and attack, but that's probably rash. Get a few more siege tanks to just put at the front here, just in case. This bunker is still up. Okay, yep, and the wraiths are still coming in furiously, but I'm just gonna keep making more and more and more and more turrets, and we should be fine. So this amount of wraiths is getting wiped out relatively fast, but I'm not that concerned because, I mean, they're consistently attacking me, but I'm not that concerned is what I'm trying to say. Okay, let's keep making these turrets. We have more and more Goliaths coming out. This is looking good, and I might just want to go ahead and repair this bunker. And I really don't know where I put that, that dropship. I'd like to make a run. We have our little mobile force here. We're going to leave right in the middle. Go ahead and siege up, buddy. And 50 minutes. 50 minutes is a long time. So we have a long time to keep up with this. So again, I'm trying to defend Brown's base for as long as possible. They're coming at me with a few of these wraiths. Not a big deal. Okay. This is looking good. We'll get a couple more extra supply depots in case we lose any. And all I'm going to do is just keep building turrets just everywhere, depending, because it seems like those wraiths just come out of nowhere. We have so much money that if we just lay down turrets everywhere, that once the battlecruisers end up coming, we should be really well defended and ready for it. Granted, we're running out of money, and I might want to take that left area, because we're going to run out of income entirely, but I think we'll be okay. Because turrets are cheap. Turrets are relatively cheap. Let's keep making these. Don't stop making these. Same up here. Let's don't stop making these. And sure, let's try to hang on to the power generator and the side disruptor. I don't even know what those are there for, but we've got them. And that's a lot of tanks right here, so we should be pretty well defended against this area. And we may want to set up some turrets down here as well to defend me against any wraiths or battlecruisers that decide to circumvent this area. There's still wraiths over here that seem to be patrolling, which is very strange, but I'm okay with that. Let's go ahead and see if we can set up some turrets over here too. Just everywhere, and this is good. I might just go ahead and, I'm just gonna build another dropship so I can ferry some SCVs over to the Brown base. And now that Brown is pretty much entirely defended just by missile turrets, I could probably push out if I made a group of wraiths and, well, I can't make battlecruisers, can I? The issue is I don't have income, and I kind of want to go and take this base. What I'm going to do is grab my new dropship. I'm going to rally it down here and pick up all these SCVs. And then we're going to fly across the map, take this, and just set up a bunch of missile turrets over there as well. And we may need to get some tanks up there if we want to hold on to it. But between all the Goliaths that we have, the tanks, and, you know, the ground game that we have going on, let's just get rid of this as well. Anything to open up some space. Wraith and Narek and Emperor Cowlin, you are fine. No enemy attacks for quite some time. I think they're scared. They know. They know they're in trouble. That's probably not true at all. But anyway, let's just keep making those turrets up in these areas where the Wraiths seem to be spawning from. And then I'll try to repair my units as well. But again, I'm trying to hold on to these bases for as long as possible. So you know what? I'm going to take my air fleet and come over here because to get rid of this patrolling Wraith, because I'm going to want to ferry some units over to that other area for income. And it seems like we have a ton of money now, but that could change. That could change very fast. Okay, let's wait for my air fleet to get over there. Also, being able to cloak could make a big difference too. Once maybe, you know, if the battlecruisers come and there's no air support, we could be in really, really good shape. Okay, there was more here than I originally expected. All these units were patrolling over here. Very, very interesting. I'm going to leave these units here for now. So my Valkyries just tear this stuff up. Let's drop one SCV and then keep going. And again, it's tempting to want to go and attack, but I'm probably not going to do that. Where did I drop that SCV? Over here. So we want to just set up a bunch of turrets over here. We'll defend it with my air fleet right now. I don't even know where these units are coming from, but it's not that big of a deal. We want to send some Wraiths down here, and some Wraiths down here, to reinforce my air group that's getting wiped out. These Wraiths are slowly making progress, but these Valkyries just need to hold out long enough for these turrets to get set up. I just need, like, four or five of them. Okay, let's move on in and defend this area, and I've been creeping closer and closer to this side, because this is where they seem to be coming from. No attack for a while. Now, keep in mind, earlier on in this mission, I can see where they're spawning from. Earlier on, I could tell where they were really focusing their attacks. Okay, let's go ahead and keep making turrets. These aren't quite getting burned down. This is what I think expected. That's a lot of battlecruisers, so I can't really deal with that right now. In the future, yes. These Wraiths, I'm not sure where they're trying to go. But what they're doing is they're stopping me from being able to move in multiple directions. Lots of Valkyries, which is fine, because I'm not doing a very heavy air attack here. I'm doing mostly turrets. Let's get out of here. Let's draw these guys into the turrets. Now turn and fight, now that they're under the turrets. We're going to lose maybe a Valkyrie here. I lost my dropship with all of the SCVs in it. And again, I'm not sure what I need to do to be able to go and take the other side of the map. I think what I need is just to make a bunch of Wraiths and Valkyries and go over and try to get rid of all those battlecruisers. But that's a lot of battlecruisers, so I'm not sure what to do. Really not sure what to do. We still have these groups of units here. Maybe what I could do is just make a command center down here. I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make a command center right here, just so I can make SCVs down here. I should have done that earlier. This seems better defended. Constant attacks in this area really don't bother me. Let's just go ahead and start repairing. Get even more turrets, honestly. And here are the ground attacks, which I'm going to unseize these folks and move them down. I probably maybe want to set some bunkers up over there instead. I move back here. I hear stuff getting attacked. We're going to hear base under attack the entirety of this duration. It's really tempting to go and attack, but their attacks respond, so I really can't afford to overextend, I don't think. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to start making Wraiths, lots and lots of Wraiths. With my remaining supply, we're going to make Wraiths. And the reason for that is so that I can go and take that left side because I need the income. So let's just go ahead and just keep repairing this, and then we should be fine. Large groups coming at me here. Let's move some Goliaths down in this area. Let's hold position on this one. And nothing's going to be able to get through this, I don't think. And I don't know if we really even have any extra income right now, which is a little scary. I don't think we have any... Do we have anything mining right now? Up here, maybe? No, we don't. I don't think we have anything. Yikes. Okay, now battle cruisers. I don't really care. Once this is done, we're going to start repairing up my Valkyries and try making a run for that leftmost base. Okay, so just start repairing these, and very slowly we'll get these repaired, and we'll worry about this later. Another battle cruiser. Oh, I thought he could make it. It's all right. Again, this is what turrets are for. This is why we're making a ton of turrets. The fact that we have another 39 minutes does sort of concern me. Does concern me a little bit. All right, Goliaths, get in here. I think we need more Goliaths at home. Now that I see what's happening here, Goliaths and Goliaths. They're leaving my... Now they're leaving the other base alone, and they're focusing on me. So we just need to remake these... We just need to remake this stuff. And once all the wraiths are done, we can cloak them and go down and try to take that right area. The amount of wraiths is crazy. I'm mostly just trying to repair here, and then we're just going to rebuild. And here comes ground attacks. Don't, Goliath, I need you to stay alive. I need these Goliaths to stay alive, so that's why I'm going to make a few more and then run them over here and hold position. I'll make even another few layers of missile turrets if necessary. I'll do it. Okay, is this done? It is. So is there a way to get over here easily, or do I have to drop? Because I think I have to drop. How much longer on these wraiths? I'm going to go ahead and save. Again, income is frightening. I may need to go to the other location. We'll see. I've got this stuff set up, so I'm feeling safe. I've got this stuff set up, so I'm feeling safe. We'll build even more. I can float this command center over there when I'm ready. In the meantime, we'll get a few extra SCVs, and we'll get a few extra SCVs for here as well. Okay, Callan is fine. Let's go ahead and get another dropship. Okay, decent amount of Goliaths. I would like to move them just right here, and then they'll hold position where they're at. Just keep making turrets. I feel like that's all we need to do is just keep making turrets. Okay, we got a few extra SCVs here. The wraiths are nearly done, and then we're going to take our air fleet because these are almost fully repaired. We'll have a nice air fleet that can go and get rid of that group. I mean, I might just send the wraiths primarily because the wraiths can cloak. I want the turrets to die. They're cheap. The Goliaths, I'd prefer to stay alive with the Charon booster. Is very, very important. Okay, and let's go ahead and take these wraiths, hotkey them, run them over to this area where our old launch bays used to be. I'm going to hotkey this group. Let's go ahead and repair the wraiths. Hotkey this group to 2, and then group 1 is going over, and we're going to see what we can do. We're not very full on energy on these wraiths, but that's okay. It's primarily just seeing if we can take this. No enemy attacks for a while now. Okay, we're coming in now, and I'm on the lookout for where those battle cruisers might be with my finger on the C key. Coordinates received. Roger. Vector locked in. Okay, they do scan. They do scan. That's good to know. Yeah, there's 6 battle cruisers here. We could force them to just scan. We may be able to just force them to use all their scans. Not sure. They probably have, what, 3 more? They can just keep doing this. I mean, with this amount of battle cruisers, look at that amount of battle cruisers. I can't take that. Even, I mean, unless we can force them to use all their scans, there's no way we can handle that amount. And so we have no income, is basically what this boils down to. We just have to survive. I'm not too worried about that, but, you know, we just have to keep in mind that we do have to survive on pretty much zero income. So as long as we keep that in mind, we're at 34 minutes. Depending on how this is going, I might just go ahead and make a shortcut, because nothing is really happening right now. Nothing is really happening right now. Let's go ahead and make a bunker here and more turrets. The next attack is probably coming soon. And yeah, I have no way to get more income, so I'm a tad concerned. What I'm going to do is take these units and come and scout down here. Maybe there's a base over here that we can take instead. That's just a random vulture. That is not a base with minerals in it, unfortunately. I'm really hoping we can find something. I do have command centers that I can float. It's just finding a place to mine. If I'm really lucky, there'll be something here. Looks like nothing. Okay. Okay, yeah, it's really just this left base, and we don't have the firepower to really stand up to that area, unfortunately. I'm gonna send my air fleet to come and meet this group, and make more turrets here. Side disruptor power generator, I think you're just there to be cosmetic. That's fine. Let's get on over here and start repairing these wraiths. Okay, and here comes the attacks. I can tell I lagged for a brief moment just because so many units just spawned out of nowhere. Okay, Goliath, let's see if we can take out this Valkyrie. And I really think I'll be able to survive for long enough. This is a pretty large attack right here. We might want to get some more Goliaths. Okay, get in here. Let's see if we can focus these down. Oh, that one's not weak at all. All right, we got to get some Goliath support in here. You Goliaths, come on down here. That was a lot of battle cruisers that just spawned out of nowhere. Okay, so let's grab air attack group and come on over, and then a few more SCVs. Let's grab one SCV that's sitting over here and come on down. We have to remake all of our missile turrets. Looks like now we need a larger group of missile turrets over here. Not a big deal. But again, we're running out of money, which makes this a little scary, but I think we'll be ultimately okay. Get out of the way. Get out of the way, Goliaths. Okay, we gotta rebuild these as well, because I don't want my tanks getting taken out. It seems like they've just entirely given up on ground attacks, which is absolutely fine with me. So we have large groups of missile turrets that are just set up to wipe out these spawning groups of units, which I am very, very happy with, and I think that we can focus down Goliaths with, or focus down battlecruisers with Goliaths. I think that's really all we need. We have a concentrated ground force here, or an anti-air force, I should say, that we're in really good shape with. Let's move these away and finish repairing here and here. Got these missile turrets set up, and it's really just seeing if we can survive for long enough on the money that we have. We're slowly running out just based on repairing stuff, so I think I need to cool it with... I can build, like, maybe 7 more missile turrets, and then that's it. So, this is becoming an issue. 30 more minutes, and Brown still has some stuff that's just sort of hanging out. If we can force enemies into them, then Brown can still help us. I'm waiting for their large attack. I mean, one thing I did was I wasted a bunch of money on stuff like this stuff up here. Okay, so at this point, I think I'm just going to stop... building, and I'm gonna hold on to the rest of my money to repair. And I do have a nice air fleet where I theoretically could go out and attack this area again, but again, there were like 8 battle cruisers there. I think those inevitably will come and attack me eventually, though. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I'll leave Colens in this bunker because that's the safe bunker. We'll make one more marine to throw into that other bunker. But ultimately, I think what it comes down to is just staying safe at this point, and let's just repair and repair. We've got 28 minutes. It really depends on how many more enemy attacks we can expect. It's like once every 5 minutes. So I think what I'll do is start cutting. I'll start cutting, and then I'll come back at each enemy attack as we can review what's happening.
Captain, they are gathering their air fleet, despite with everything they have. Looks like a final desperate attempt to break our defenses. They have an overwhelming number of ships. We must go on the offensive while maintaining a solid defense and eliminate as many of their air forces as possible. If we do not, when they strike, we will quite literally be overwhelmed.
The enemy fleet will strike with everything they have very soon. You can either build a strong defense and hope to survive their assault, or go on the offensive and destroy their ships while maintaining a good defense. Well, I've used all my money in the defense, so I think what I'm going to do, and I know this might be a little crazy, is I think I'm just going to go ahead and hold on with what I have. And continue to make cuts in between the attacks. I mean, this is the first thing I've heard. I've been sitting here for like 3 to 4 in-game minutes, nothing has happened. But I've got my groups of Wraiths and Goliaths, and I actually think that I could take out, like, if say they sent like 12 battle cruisers from 2 different directions. I think that I could handle that. It would be close, but I really think I could. I have missile turrets like literally everywhere. There's no way they could destroy all of my stuff before that happens. And all I have to really do is grab, do I have a dropship? I could just put Colens in a dropship and just have these three guys go to like the corner of the map. And you know, I set up all these missile turrets in my side bases too, so that the enemy will move up and attack towards them first. And I theoretically would be okay, but I just cannot afford to go on the offensive right now. I think the best thing for me to have done earlier would have been to take tanks and try to push through this area. I mean, I don't even know what's in here. What I'd have to do is hotkey my comset stations and just sort of scan through here to see what we were really up against. I mean, they have some stuff on the high ground here, but I think I could have probably made a move on this base with ground forces. But unfortunately, now it's too late. So yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and make a cut and wait until they attack me next. Okay, I've been sitting for a while and nothing's been happening, so I think what I'm gonna do is take this group of wraiths and see if I can poke in and just kill a few more of these air forces that are hanging out on the left side, because, I mean, there are scans. If I can draw out the scans, then I'll be in fine shape. I mean, I am 3-3. Let's go ahead and cloak and just force them to use scans. See how many scans we can force them to use. And I want to go on the outskirts here, so hold position. That's the way to do it. Got my finger on the H key so I can instantly kill these wraiths, and again, it's forcing them to use those scans. Then we move up, see if we find any more. Yep, and again, we're getting them to use tons and tons of scans. Battlecruiser's not sure what to do. Drawing out another scan. And we're going to do this pretty much until we run out of energy. And they're getting one or two shots off on us each time, but that's not a big deal. It really just depends on how many scanner sweeps they really can have. Not sure. So move on in, hold position, get out before they attack me. Nice. And I'm just trying to snipe as much as I can here, because this area seems very saturated with enemies. Whoa. How long did that scanner sweep not last for? Okay, I see now what they're saying with overwhelming force. That is a pretty large force here. We're getting low on energy. I might want to pull out. I could repair with my remaining money. I'm kind of enjoying this, though. I think I'm going to keep it up. Okay, another scan down. They can't have unlimited energy. I've scanned around the map, and it looks like they have three, maybe four scanners. Comset stations, which means they have 12 scanners sweeps. And we've burned through a decent amount of them already. There goes another one. Okay, let's get out of here. We don't want to aggravate those battlecruisers. I'm going to stay cloaked because decloaking and cloaking actually takes more energy than anything else. Another scanner sweep? How many do they have? I haven't been counting, but I've drawn out a decent amount of them. And there's just a lot of wraiths. I'm not sure if they're building these wraiths or what, but I am taking them out as they're coming. Another scanner sweep. I would love to just have full rain on this group of battlecruisers. Can you imagine how awesome that would be? Is if I could just maintain full... If I could just maintain full cloaking on these things? Oh, with whoa, no scanner sweep! We're gonna, of course, right now we're gonna run out of energy, but I see now why we have to do this. Let's kill as many as we can. Oh dear, how many can we kill? We have to get a decent amount. And again, we used all of our scanner, or we got them to use all their scanner sweeps, which was kind of a cheeky tactic. Okay, now let's get out of here. Okay, we gotta get out of here. Let's go ahead and decloak. Decloak. We have more wraiths at home. I just killed a decent amount of battlecruisers. I think I got rid of maybe half that force, so I'm pretty happy with that. Now, unfortunately, I just don't have enough money to continue anything like that. But we did burn through, again, most of their energy. Now, the thing is, the energy on their comsats comes back about as fast as it comes back on my wraiths, so I can't really do anything like that again, unless I just go headlong right into them with the Valkyries as well, which could work, but it really just depends on how many they have here. It doesn't look like they're reinforcing this group. It looks like they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, maybe 8, just depending on how they're stacked, which is fine. If they have another group maybe on this side of the map, I think we'd be okay. But again, I think that went very well for me. I was able to get a good idea of what we were up against. It looked like, I remember when they came in from off the screen, they were down here, weren't they? Or were they up here? I might as well just keep scanning around, and it's about that time I might just start cutting again as we wait and see how they're going to attack. Do I want to repair those wraiths? I might just want to repair the really, really weak ones up to a reasonable level. And I could go in with one Wraith at a time to draw out the scanner sweeps in order to conserve energy. And that actually might be the best thing to do as we wait for these Wraiths to get energy back. We might be able to make one more strike in on them again by doing the same thing. I'll give it a shot. So let's fly on down here. Let's cloak. And get them to just draw out their scanner sweep. Well, let's go to the battlecruisers and do it. They can't chase us as effectively. I mean, they're even protected by, like, flanks of Wraiths. Okay, there's one. Hold position. It's hard for me to judge how long it really takes them. Another scan. And I'm waiting. And during this time, my energy is coming back on my own Wraiths. Okay. Another scan. That's three. If they have three scanner sweeps, or if they have three scanners, comset stations, that would imply that that's all the energy they've gotten back on them. There's one more. Gotta back a little further away from that one this time. Hold position. Meanwhile, let's take this group of Wraiths and come over and meet this one, and we can cover him and be ready to go in when it's time, basically. So we're gonna fly back in. Another scanner sweep. Those guys are actually kind of ignoring me, which is good. Let's get rid of some of these outlying Wraiths. I think it's time. Let's go ahead and cloak. We've drawn out a lot of scanner sweeps. Let's see how many more they really have. Looks like they used two right there. That's awesome. Are they reinforcing those battlecruisers? I don't think so. 7 minutes, 45 seconds. I'm trying to keep this interesting rather than just sitting in my base. I have enough Goliaths that I could probably maintain this for a long time. Come on now. Another scanner sweep. And we're also doing damage to them even with these single volleys, so this is working out quite well for me, I think. Keep moving away. Get back in there. Okay, nope. Still there. Got that Wraith before it could do any more damage to us. And once again, we're running short on energy here, so we just gotta do as much as we can. Another scan. How many are there? Good lord, they have so much energy to blow on this. I guess they have as much energy as my Wraiths did as they when they were able to get back their energy, so it's... Yep, that's it. Alright, so we're gonna run out of energy here before we can really do anything else, so I think this venture is over, unfortunately. Well, I'll try one more time. But we're about to run out of energy on my Wraith, so this...
This is it. Find myself. They're coming in full force with everything they have. We will likely be overwhelmed in some sectors. I recommend if one of our expansions is the first target, and we do not hold out, we simply abandon it. Our fleet is almost here. We must hold out.
Okay, 6 minutes. Unfortunately, I really wasn't able to do much there. But we just have to survive for 5.5 minutes. It really just depends on what direction they come from. So we'll send these Wraiths up here to get repaired so that they can cloak and try to take out some more enemies. Now, keep in mind, I've done pretty well to get rid of their expansions. So we should be good there. And of course, they're gonna attack me from an unexpected location. So let's grab, I think we have like one Goliath down here. Let's go and attack these Wraiths and try to pull them into my missile turrets. And yeah, they're coming at me from multiple angles. This stuff is gonna get smoked. I don't really care about this. I just gotta be on the lookout for Ko Lang. Never mind, that Goliath isn't gonna be able to do anything. So let's grab my... Let's go ahead and grab my air fleet and move it up here and just to get it home and defend Ko Lang. Alternatively, we go ahead and defense matrix the Emperor and get him right in there. I'm gonna save right now. Okay, groups of Wraiths attacking into my missile turrets. Good for them. Okay, and here they're pushing through the brown base, but again, I do have a solid defense here, and I just need to draw them into my missile turrets, and they will get slowly whittled away. Okay, overall, I'd say so far this is going just fine. I mean, they're attacking these buildings and not attacking into my units, so let's see if we can attack them and try to draw them into us. We can actually kite the battlecruisers with Goliaths, I think. We're very, very careful. And it's working. That's two more battlecruisers down, and I think because I whittled them away earlier, we're in good shape. They're also 0-0-0. Eventually, they're gonna have to attack into my defensive emplacement, so there's no way, I think, that they're really gonna be able to do too much. Let's go ahead and move the Emperor back. Emperor Kaolin back. Kaolin? I'm not sure. Okay, so these battlecruisers did make it through these defenses. I'm not that concerned because there really weren't that many here, and at most they're going to end up moving it up in this direction. We could take the Valkyries and get down there and try to attack. And then my other Wraiths, did they all die? Or did I move them home? They must have all died. So do your best, Valkyries. This probably was not wise, actually. Let's see if we can get any of these out. We got three out. And let's go ahead and grab some of these Goliaths and see if we can kite around a few of these battlecruisers. Again, this is all about just delaying. The fact that we're able to delay here, we only need to survive for two more minutes. There's no way even that amount of battlecruisers can destroy all of our remaining buildings. Our only liability is our heroes, and they appear okay. I noticed we're getting attacked up here. So these missile turrets that were set up here were not in vain. Let's move these back and see if we can even mass repair some of these turrets. We're going to end up using all of our money to do that, but honestly, I think it's fine. I think we set up turrets over here, too, so we're in very, very good shape. Okay, so I grabbed these guys for a reason, because we want to try to kite these battlecruisers. I'm going to hold position kite, as I was doing before. This one, I think I'm just going to go ahead and fight head-on rather than trying to kite. Cool, two more down. 59 seconds. These other units are going to be coming up towards me from the right, but I think we're good. We do have these units. I mean, he was talking about let the expansions go. I agree. Didn't I have a larger group of Goliaths somewhere? They must have all died. Well, maybe they didn't die, but they were probably... A lot of them are up here. Nothing else has attacked me. Let's grab these Goliaths and move them up in this direction, if they can even make their way there, because everything's sort of path-blocked at this point. I could get the Emperor up there just in case, but we don't have much money to be able to repair him. But we could Yamato. Actually, I'm going to do that. I'm going to grab my heroes just in case and move them over. 2 seconds, though, never mind. Our fleet's here, so we are completely safe. Heroic music, we did it! Good job, boys. Unfortunately, this expansion is going down as my SCV... Are they retreating? They are. They're retreating. That's pretty neat. Okay, well, that's good, because we are just completely out of cash. My command center's still alive. I'm going to lift it and move it over here. Just in... For whatever reason, there's more to this. And there very well might be. Who knows? So the music is playing, but nothing is really happening right now. Oh, they decided to come down here instead. That's fine. So is the fleet here, or... There it is. Okay.
It's here. I mean, well done. Well done indeed.
Okay, and now the fleet is probably going to tear through this this remaining base, I think. Oh, good. Okay, good. Yes, destroy their base. I mean, you're not really in the best of spots. Not really in the best of spots, Imperial Fleet, but honestly, I guess this is fine. I guess this is fine. These battlecruisers are just sitting here. That's cool with me. But we survived. Most of the Brown base was destroyed, but it did its job. More battlecruisers and Wraiths coming in. Tons and tons of stuff. These battlecruisers are just sitting here. I would have expected them to try to help a little bit, but they are doing nothing. And I suppose we'll just sit here and watch as these bases slowly get wiped out. I guess it would have been fun to go on the offensive, but I just wasn't sure what to expect. The Empire fleet easily overtook the remaining resistance forces. More resistance forces, seeing defeat was inevitable, surrendered. Kolenz quickly began reinstating his security procedures while the Empire fleet flew proudly overhead, a massive armada and a testament to the sheer might of the Empire. Okay, so I'm seeing credits here. What I suspect is perhaps Desler made this map. It was a very long map just to show, like, hey, look at this cool thing that I made. And the popularity was high enough that he decided to... Oh, Nexus Core Studios. That's the Oracle and I think Joel Studler back in the day. The Nexus Core Studios still exists, though, and the Oracle is remaking Legacy of the Confederation here pretty soon. I think we'll see a demo pretty shortly. I think, I hope. Not sure what we're watching here. Was that Kolenz? I think it was. There he is. There's Joel Studler. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. There's the Emperor and Graith and Narek as well. Chief Interrogator, Graith and Narek. Oh, it's saying Joel did both of those roles. We'll see who was Cowlin. He was all three of them. Very interesting. Yeah, so Joel used to do a ton of, I mean, I think he made all the portraits for these older custom campaigns. Some people were saying they thought Celestial Eruption was one of his best works. So there are a lot more missions to this campaign. I think that this one was made, and it was very long, you notice, just to be like, look at this thing I'm thinking of making. The popularity was high enough that he decided to continue with the campaign. That's the impression that I get from this right now. Cerebrit Nugdris. Was Cerebrit Nugdris in this mission? Did we see Cerebrit Nugdris? Lieutenant Commander Roger Shaddix Norman was not in this campaign, but was from EDAS. Now, I think actually this campaign proceeds as if those unmade EDAS episodes actually... And there was Rond. Actually completed, like the story existed. So, I'd advise, you know, go ahead and check out those... You should go out and check out those story synopses so you can see, I guess, where we are. I'll read them more in depth so that as we move forward through this campaign, I can have a better idea of what's really supposed to be happening. But honestly, it just seems like there's a new empire in the Kaprulu sector. It's ruling the Kaprulu sector, and some people are trying to resist it. And that pretty much seems like the base of this story right now. And obviously, it may get more complex. We may see some stuff from Fall from Grace with Rond. We might see some stuff from Edas come out here pretty soon. So it may all tie together because this is all part of Celestial stories. Marco Hernandez is Desler, who really seemed like he was ahead of his time with some of these campaigns. I mean, you can also see how he's improved. Like, EDAS, the voice acting, not good. But then as we moved into this campaign, the voice acting is quite good. You see a big improvement. Very cool. I have some editing to do here to get rid of those lag periods where nothing was happening. And that's how a lot of these older holdout missions were. Like, newer holdout missions, like if you look at the holdout missions from Legacy of the Void, it's really about keeping mild pressure on the player all the time. This is just sending big waves with large periods of nothing in between, so. Interesting. I feel like something's about to happen, so I'm trying to end my thought. Let's see what happens here. Everything on the map has not gone neutral yet, so it's not over. Yet.
I want to know how this was allowed to happen on our territory. This kind of thing should never happen.
Unfortunately, my liege, they knew exactly when everything would happen. They knew when our fleet was off on exercise drills. They knew exactly when to sabotage the platform to coincide with your leaving. They knew our defenses, and they used all of that against us. Combined with the utter ignorance of my security procedures on the part of the men, this is how the situation developed, my liege.
Are you saying that some of the soldiers here on base were not following your orders?
Well, I was off on shore leave. They probably thought they could...
execute them. Immediately.
My leash, I don't think that is necessary.
I am certain what the captain means is that he will entrust the task to me. Sire, if I may, we captured several prisoners. I should begin interrogating them immediately. In addition, we also captured a noted resistance member, Ilya Klum. Do it, Narek. Captain Lentz, take the fleet to the town of Thamasi. Leave immediately and you should arrive by nightfall. I will give you more instructions when you arrive.
At once, my liege.
Oh! Alright, we did it! Let's see what the victory screen looks like. It'll be nice to have a victory after this 2-hour-long mission. Look at that! Listen to that music! The music is so joyous in this campaign. Well, alright, this has been Jay Barino. Thanks for joining me. I'll see you in mission 2. Bye now.